Hello everybody, myself Prashant Mukhopadhyay, faculty member, Electrical Engineering Department, Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management. So in our last class, we have discussed three-phase dual converters, its operations, waveforms, in different mode, that is in circulating current free mode and circulating current mode. And also we have discussed some problems regarding three-phase converters. As I told you, we will discuss in this class, at the end of the last class, that we'll discuss today, that is effect of source inductance on the performance of AC to DC converters, particularly controlled rectifiers. So once again, I'm telling you, today's topic of discussion is effect of source inductance on the performance of controlled rectifiers or AC to DC converters. So what is the objective, instructional objectives of this subject, particularly on completion of the this topic? A student will be able to draw the voltage and current waveforms associated with a converter, taking into account the effect of source inductance. Find the average output voltage of the converter as a function of the firing angle and overlap angle. Estimate overlap angles under a given operating condition, and hence determine the turnoff time available for the thyristors. And draw the equivalent circuit of the converter and parameterize it. And also find out the voltage stress on the thyristors due to commutation overlap. So this is very important. So what you will be able to learn after completion of this discussion. So that is, I told you, that is you can draw voltage and current waveforms of the converters, taking this effect of source inductance. Also, you are able to find out the average output voltage of the converter. That is a function of the firing angle and overlap angle. Already, you have discussed all these things. So that is, we have the output voltage as a function of firing angle. So, only thing is that how it will be modified or changed with the introduction of the source inductance in the systems. And you are also able to estimate the overlap angles under a given operating condition, and then determine the turn-off time available for the thyristors. And you will be able to draw the equivalent circuit of a converter, and you can parameterize it. And also you can find out the voltage stress on the thyristors due to commutation overlap. So let us start. So how the concept of source inductance coming into the systems, that will be introduced first. Because in our earlier discussions, we have taken the input AC power sources supplying an AC to DC power converter have been assumed to be ideal with no source impedance. And although this assumption simplifies the analysis of the converters, in most of practical situations, they are not fully justified, actually. So most AC to DC converters are supplied from transformers. The series impedance of the transformer can always be neglected. Even if no transformer is used, the impedance of the feeder line comes in series with the source. And in most cases, the impedance is predominantly inductive with negligible resistive components. The presence of source inductance does have a significant effect on the performance of the converter. So with source inductance present, the output voltage of the converter does not remain constant for a given firing angle. Instead, it drops gradually with load current, and the converter output voltage and input current performance also change significantly. So in this today's discussion, a quantitative analysis of these effects will be taken up in some details. So with this, we can discuss first the single phase fully controlled converter with source inductance. So this is the figure which shows the source inductance with the single phase systems from where the AC supply is provided to the converter. Okay, single phase converter. So this is a fully controlled converter with source inductance. And for simplicity, it has been assumed that the converter operates in the continuous conduction mode. Further, it has been assumed that the load current ripple is negligible and the load can be replaced by DC current source. This is a DC current source. Load can be replaced by DC current source. The magnitude of which equals the average load current. So basically, this load current equivalent to the DC current source. And this figure B actually shows this is the operation of single phase fully controlled converter with source conductance and their waveforms actually. Okay, so basically this corresponding waveforms are shown in figure B, and it is assumed that the thyristor T3 and T4 while conducting at initially, that is at time t equal to 0, this T3 and T4 was in conduction mode. And T1 and T2 are fired at omega t equal to alpha. So T1 and T2 are fired at, if there are no source inductance, T3 and T4 would have commutated as soon as T1 and T2 are turned on. But due to this presence of the source inductors, the input current polarity would have changed instantaneously because during this conduction through this T3 and T4 to this, so the energy will be stored here. Okay, so as a result, the input current polarity would have changed instantaneously when this T3 and T4 will turn off. And would have commutated as soon as so however, if a source inductance is present in the commutation and the change of input current polarity cannot be instantaneous, so therefore when T1 and T2 are turned on, T2 and T4 does not commute immediately, so instead for some interval all four thyristors continue to conduct. That is shown in figure B. This interval is called the overlap interval. So this is shown here. Actually, this is the overlap zone. Okay, T3, T4, and T1, T2 both are conducting. So actually, this overlap interval. So during this period, load current freewheels through the thyristors, and the output voltage is clamped to zero. On the other hand, the input current starts changing polarity as the current through T1 and T2 increases and T3 and T4 current decreases. See, here it is. So, okay. So it is increases and it is going on decreasing. Yeah. So as a result, and at the end of the overlap interval, the current through T3 and T4 becomes zero, and they commutate. And then T1 and T2 start conducting the full load current. And the same process repeats during the commutation from T1 and T2 to T3 and T4 at omega t equal to pi plus alpha. So that is here, shown here. Okay. And this is pi. This is pi plus alpha. So actually, this is pi plus alpha this time. Here. So as a result, this is the one that I'm doing. Okay. So it is clear that the commutation overlap not only reduces average output DC voltage but also reduces the extinction angle gamma, which may cause commutation failure in the inverting mode of operation if alpha is very close to 180 degree. And in the following analysis and expression of the overlap angle, mu will be determined. Mu. This is actually overlap angle. Okay. So this is for when T3 and T4 is commutated, going to be commutated, and T1 and T2 are on. So this is the reverse. So T1 and T2 is getting turned off, and T2 and T3 and T4 is turned on. As a result, what is happening? So this output voltage and output current is decreasing. So actually, This is the equivalent circuit, basically equivalent circuit of during overlap period. So this is the equivalent circuit. Here the output, this is the output. So as I told you, the load current is being replaced with a DC current source. Okay. So from this equivalent circuit, the converter during the overlap period will be this, we can write. So this is equal to this VI, L DI DT equal to VI, for omega T is between alpha to alpha plus say mu. Okay, so actually then if we put I at omega t equal to alpha, that is equal to minus I zero. Okay, so I input current is equal to I minus this. So when omega t equal to alpha, we can put this equal like this. Okay, so this is actually I equal to this. This is the I. Yes. Okay. So x. So with this, we can at omega t equal to alpha plus mu, so it will be II equal to input current equal to this output current. This will be expression will be like this. Okay, so in this cos alpha minus cos of alpha plus mu is equal to this. Okay, so from this you can calculate it. So output voltage is 1 by pi alpha to alpha plus pi equal to this waveform. So it will, Jarrell found it. Okay. Alpha to alpha plus here. So as a result, what is happening? So after calculation, this will be your output voltage will be like this. So this is output voltage expressions. Okay, it's just calculation only. So the equivalent, this equation for output voltage can be defined by the following equivalent circuit. So this is, okay, like this. Clear? So this is the equivalent circuit representation of a fully controlled rectified single phase with source inductance. So this simple equivalent circuit represents the single phase fully controlled converter with source inductance as a practical DC source as far as its average behavior is concerned. And the open circuit voltage of this practical source equal to the average DC output voltage of an ideal converter, so without source inductance, operating at a firing angle of alpha. And the voltage drop across the internal resistance, if we say it is RC, the voltage lost due to overlap shown in the waveform diagram. So by the hatched portion of the output waveform. So this is shown here. Actually, this is okay. This hatched portion. So with this, so this is called a commutation resistance, that way it is called RC. This is commutation resistance, although this resistance accounts for the voltage drop correctly. There is no power loss associated with this resistance, since the physical process of overlap does not involve any power loss. Therefore, this resistance should be used carefully where power calculation is involved. Okay, so this is actually about the effect of source inductance in a single phase fully controlled converter circuits. So how this with this presence of source inductance, that means is say creating overlap between that four thyristors, that is when set of thyristors is getting commutated due to the source inductance. It will not getting commutated instantaneously as the other set T1 T2 is getting on. So rather there is a overlap zone, that is mu. and as a result of this overlap junction, how this output DC voltage reduces, as well as extinction angles also reduces. Now we'll discuss about the three-phase control converter with source inductance. So how the source inductance will affect the three-phase fully controlled converter. So this will be discussed right now. Three-phase fully controlled converter we have already analyzed with ideal source with no internal impedance. But when the source inductance is taken into account, the qualitative effects of on the performance of the converter is similar to that in the case of a single phase converter. So this figure actually shows such a converters with source inductance. As in the case of a single phase converter, the load is assumed to be highly inductive, such that load can be replaced by current source. Here also load can be replaced by current source. So only difference is that we have taken it three phase, otherwise everything is same, the circuit diagram itself. So this is the actually waveform. So so operation three phase fully controlled converter with source inductance. These are the waveforms. So this is actually the line voltage, then say current, this is overlap, and this is actually output. Okay, so as in case of single phase converter, commutation are not commutations are not instantaneous due to presence of source inductance. It takes place over an overlap period of mu1, say here, instead during this overlap period, three thyristors instead of two conducts, current in the outgoing thyristors gradually decreases to zero, while the incoming thyristor current increases and equal to the total load current at the end of the overlap period. And if the duration of the overlap period is greater than 60 degree, a fourth thyristor may also conduct clamping the output voltage to zero for some time. However, this situation is not very common and will not be discussed any further in this discussion today. So due to conduction of two devices during commutations, either from the top group or the bottom group, the instantaneous output voltage during the overlap period that is shown here in the hatched line, this is the overlap period, will be resulting in reduced average voltage. The exact amount of this reduction can be calculated as follows. So in the time interval omega t between alpha plus mu, T6 and T2 from the bottom group and T1 from the top group conduct. So three thyristors are conducting at a time. So the equivalent circuit of the conduction of the converter during this period is given in this way. So this is the equivalent circuit. So equivalent circuit during the commutation from T6 to T2, and in the interval say omega between alpha equal to omega t to alpha plus mu, so the equations will be like this: dB equal to L dIV dt minus L dIC dt plus VC. So from these equations you can write this. Okay, so so actually, we can write VBC, that is VB minus VC, equal to L DDT IB minus IC. Okay, VB minus VC is VBC. So here it is, actually. Okay, so this is actually given by L DDT of depends of this current IB minus IC. But you know, as per KCL, the IB plus IC plus IE there is output current equal to this is the constant current source which is replacing the load current, so I is equal to 0, so it is here. Here, this and this should be meeting at a point, so at junction this is equal to 0. So we can write again dB dIB dt equal to minus dIC dt of IC. So dt IB equal to minus of dt IC. So if you put here, actually F2L dt IB actually if you put minus IC equal to this one, so 2L dt IB equal to VBC, that is equal to root 2 VL sine omega. So therefore IB equal to C minus this, okay, C equal to at omega t equal to alpha, so actually we can write IB equal to minus IG, so therefore C equal to this, okay, so this. So therefore we can write this equal to this, so omega t equal to alpha plus mu, so I equal to 0, so if you put here, so this is the expression, so this is this equation holds for mu greater than equal to less than equal to 60, and it can be shown from this condition, for this condition to be satisfied, so this will be the condition, so I 0 or less than should be equal to this. So calculate the DC voltage for omega t in between alpha to alpha plus mu. So V output voltage V0 equal to V minus VB plus L this dt of IB equal to 3 by 2 VA. So therefore if we put here that for alpha plus omega t is between alpha plus mu to alpha plus 5 by 3, output is VS. So put here. So this expression, actually this will be like this, so go on calculation, after calculating we will get this, and then we substitute the for this proportion, this value to omega L VL by I0. So if we put this into this equation of output voltage V0 or V output, so we can write it, this will be like this, okay. So this equation says the same DC equivalent circuit for the three phase. Okay. Three phase converter with source inductance. That will be with VOC equal to this. And this is the commutation resistance RC equal to 3 by pi omega. So it's and it can be noted that RC is a lossless in the resistance that we have already discussed, so since the overlap process does not involve any active power loss. So we have told it in our say single phase say converter case also, you know, for the effect of the source inductance. So with this we can conclude the effect of source inductance, so that is not only it will reduce due to the overlap of three thyristors, say sometimes four, so actually output voltage will be reduced, and this process should be taken into consideration, but in every case we cannot assume that source inductance is zero, basically this is not possible. So for calculation this effect should be taken into consideration. So now we'll discuss one or two problems with this. So here it is another problem, 220 volt 1450 rpm 100 ampere separately excited DC motor has an armature resistance of 0.1 ohm. It is supplied from a 3 phase fully controlled converter connected to 3 phase 50 hertz AC source. The AC source has an inductive reactance, this is the source reactance of 0.5 ohm at 50 Hz. The line voltage is adjusted such that at alpha equal to 0, the motor operates at rated speed and torque. The motor is to be braked regeneratively in the reverse direction at the rated speed using the converter. Then what is the maximum braking torque the motor will be able to produce under this condition without causing compression failure? So this under rated operating conditions, motor terminal voltage is 220 and it is 100 amperes current that is given. So if then from this equation of the output voltage, if you put this the values, we'll get this is the line voltage 198. So EB at rated speed, back EMF, so this will be like this. So this is actually I and this is R. So this is supply coming from 220 minus this IRA that is equal to 210 volt. So under regenerative braking in the reverse direction at rated speed, so this actually 198, if you put this value, this alpha into minus this plus 0.1, so that is your resistance. So the into I0 will be equal to minus 210 volt. So from this we can find out this value. Okay, and at the limiting conditions of the commutation failure, so this should be almost equal to 180 degree. So thus the cos alpha equal to like this, okay, minus 1. So we can write therefore for this, so this is the output current. Therefore, maximum braking torque will be approximately 150% of the rated motor torque. So, with this, actually, the effect of source inductance on the performance of single phase and three phase converters is being discussed. So, we have taken the help of the reference book, as I told you in our earlier class also. Maybe here we have taken the Rashid Power Electronics Circuit Devices and Applications by BJ and PC Sense Power Electronics by Tara McGrohill and Power Electronics Converters Application and Design by Mohan Anderland Robbins. So John Willy and Sean. So these are the references. Also, we have taken the help of NPTEL lectures. And after that, we can summarize the today's lesson as AC power source, AC supply, and AC to DC converter have internal impedance which are not always negligible. The internal impedance of an AC source is predominantly inductive with negligible resistive components. That's why we have taken replace the load current as a DC current source. And due to the presence of the source inductance in the AC line, the thyristors in an AC to DC converter cannot commutate instantaneously. The period over which the commutation process continues is called the overlap period. The length of overlap period increases with increasing source inductance and load current. In a single phase converter, all four thyristors conduct during overlap period. In a three phase converters, three thyristors conduct during overlap period provided it is less than 60 degree. Then the average output voltage of a converter decreases as a result of the commutation overlap. And the voltage drop due to commutation overlap can be represented as a drop across a commutation resistance, and the value of which is proportional to the AC line reactance per phase, the RC actually. And the commutation resistance is lossless since the actual process of overlap does not involve any real power loss. And commutation overlap reduces the margin angle gamma of a converter and may cause commutation failure. Commutation overlap introduces notches in the AC supply voltage waveform, which may affect other equipment connected to the same power source. So these are the lessons summary, and hope you have say understood it. And so this is very important that in every case we cannot neglect the say source inductance, and this basically this source inductance is very much inductive. If we neglect the resistive components of the source impedance part, so this presence of this inductance will affect.